Here comes Biffle. Greg Biffle is back to the lead, and he convincingly crosses the bow of Jimmy Johnson's number 48. Now that was one of those I'll get even with yous, as Jimmy put the move on Greg earlier.
Well, we heard Greg say, I'm going to let him do whatever he's going to do. I'm saving my equipment. Now, I got to say, he didn't save a whole lot right there on that pass.
Yeah. Oh, it looked like Jimmy Johnson's in the wall.
Jimmy Johnson just got in the wall down here in 3 and 4. The whole right side of the car. I think he hit it hard, but he got up against it.
Now he's staying on track at speed. Woo! There it is.
That's a pretty hard lick. Looks like that Trevor Bayne.
Yeah, I think so.
But as you said, Darrell, the strength of these cars and their ability to take a shot, Johnson.
Right, taps through the wall, right side of the wall into 3. Right.
Johnson is still at speed.
Yeah, but he's now losing about a half a second a lap to Greg Biffle. 32.30 to Greg Biffle's 31.70.
And the guy that they need to be talking to, Biffle, can slow down just a little bit. Don't let the same thing happen to you. That's what I was worried about late in this run, trying a little too hard and getting up into that wall.
Well, we listened in on Greg Biffle and team as we close down to 9 laps to go.
I'm pretty impressed that Jimmy Johnson can hang on here with that car being in the shape it's in. Looks like he's going to manage to finish second.
Mark Martin's been able to gain no ground in trying to become NASCAR's oldest Sprint Cup race winner. Not that age is a factor as far as Martin's concerned. Jeff Gordon in fourth, Matt Kenseth in fifth.
The big thing that Greg Biffle wants to see is the white flag. He wants to see that white flag, because when he sees the white flag, we know we've got a race then.
Yeah, everybody's got to hold their position one more time by, and you get the white flag next time.
Kyle Busch has won that battle with Denny Hamlin as they fought for 12th place, the last two cars on the lead lap. And now that they're single file, perhaps Biffle will work his way past them. He has 3.2 seconds in the bank on Jimmy Johnson.
No need to push. Just ride. White flag. One to go. It's a race.
White flag right there. White flag.
Final lap. 49 races since Greg Biffle's last win. It came in Kansas in the fall of 2010.
I think Marcus Ambrose out of gas down the back.
Oh. Down low, not at speed, is Ambrose, but he's going to make it around. And here comes Biffle to become the 6th different winner of 2012. Greg Biffle wins the Samsung Mobile 500. Jimmy Johnson comes home second, 3.2 seconds back.
Awesome job.
Just like Greg Biffle would have planned it out. He got a great jump, and the others were racing hard. Keselowski coming at him, though.
I think Keselowski did a good job to fend off the 5-car Casey Kane, and now he's on Biffle.
Got a shot to win. Here they come to the white flag.
Flag one more time around.
Last lap at Michigan. Biffle in the 16, Keselowski in the 2 for the win. Half a lap to go. Will he get a shot? Keselowski trying to wheel it. It's not sticking. Greg Biffle entered the race second in the championship. He leaves with the point lead. Biffle wins at Michigan. Keselowski barely over Kane for second.
Once we get into this lap, if anything should happen down in turn 1 or 2 or 3 and 4, it's over.
Pre-car breakaway. Junior tucked up tight under the bumper of Biffle. Kenseth leads to turn 1, final lap.
Denny Hamlin in the 11's there with no one to push him.
Actually, he might actually be hurting those two cars in front of him if he gets back too far. But here we go. If it's going to happen, it's going to happen pretty quick.
We've seen where the timing of where you do it is so critical.
And those two cars, the 16 and the 88, should be able to get by. But, Kenseth, if Biffle elects to take the chance.
Ford Chevrolet off the final corner. Matt Kenseth trying to win it for the second time. Here comes Junior to the outside. Side by side with Kenseth. He runs out of time. Matt Kenseth wins the Daytona 500.
I tip my hat.
I know Matt can't talk to you, but thanks to Jimmy.
2009.
Awesome, man. Awesome.
I tip my hat to Matt, Greg Biffle, though. He could have jumped out of line, but he honored his teammate.
Matt Kenseth, the first driver.
Stewart to the lead at the white flag. We're on the last lap. Will they make it back?
Well, he was fast the fast one. He's got the 49 pushing him here.
Four deep behind Stewart and Kenseth.
Yeah, Kevin Harvick's got some real help coming towards the front here.
Michael Waltrip in the 55. Into the picture. Pushed by Casey Mears. Kenseth with Harvick behind him. Oh, there's contact. Stewart into the middle of the pack and over.
Watch it out.
Huge wreck to end this race. Matt Kenseth is going to get to the finish line first. Is everybody okay?
So Matt Kenseth, see the band-aids hanging off the back bumper of that 17 car. It was earlier when Matt Kenseth got into the outside wall. Back at lap number 173, Eric Almirola spun in front of him racing for the lead. In the jam-up, Matt got into the outside wall with the right side of that car. He had to give up a lot of track position, pitting under a subsequent caution at lap 177 and went all the way to 24th place. And the white flag is up. We're in the last lap today at Kansas, a race that's featured 14 cautions. A very tough toll on car and driver. Many, many rallies on the day, including this 17 from as far as 24th in the pack. Final corners here for Matt. Checkered flag is
here's
up.
The checkers.
Third win of the season, second of the chase. Matt Kenseth wins at Kansas.
Oh, man. Guys, way to go. Great job. Gosh, great job, guys. Thank you.
Brad Keselowski finishes eighth. Jimmy Johnson ninth. Denny Hamlin 13th.
Turn three. Tommy Baldwin
yellow
gets piled
down.
Up.
Yellow.
With the 42 of Montoya,
fours in there too.
Landon Castle, Martin Truex, Carl Edwards are all involved as one car slowed in the top lane. Terry Labonte and everybody else piled in. Caution.
A lot of damage to Dave Blaney's 36 and a host of others.
Several cars were running out of gas. Watch the two white cars on the inside line as they come to turn three.
Looked like Blaney might have hooked.
Was that Castle?
Castle, I think it was, and yep. That started that. And then Jeff Gordon gets pounded by Martin Truex Jr. He hit that wall hard, Jeff Gordon did.
Now he drove away. Jeff Gordon is okay. Here's another look. Almirola way down inside,
yeah.
And it was not Castle, but Almirola and Blaney
yeah.
trigger this.
It almost looks like there was something wrong with Almirola's car, either out of fuel or something.
We were seeing a lot of drivers that appeared had something going on that last lap before this.
Boy, watch Jeff right here. He gets turned up the hill.
Nowhere for Montoya and the 42 to go.
Right inside. Carl.
Not sure if Almirola was trying to come back up onto the racing surface or if perhaps he got hooked by Blaney there to start that. Truex came down and collected Jeff Gordon.
Bam. That's a hard lift.
It's a hard hit into the safety.
Some days life feels perfect. Other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing. We can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable.